I've got champagne, so let's toast. It's Mark, maakudesuyo. We're here in Elilai, rumored to be the best restaurant in Palau. And we had some bread, which was like, it had this garlic mayonnaise-y type thing. And it was really good. I don't even know if you can hear me because there's a lot of music going on in the background, but whatever. That was good. That's it, that's my review of that. Then we moved on to the appetizer, which is the three Palawan dishes. It's mangrove clams, which are these tiny clams, and they kind of explode inside with something like a mirin-like broth inside. That's good. And then in the middle of it was the land crab, and the land crab had great flavor. It wasn't too, it didn't feel like it was fishy. It had that strong crab taste, which was a little bit like fibrous in terms of its texture. It's really soft. It was very tasty. And it had this sauce that tasted a little bit like it came from inside the crab. And then it was the nambang. Basically, it's this fish that is has this flour deep fried, right? Yeah, wrapped in flour and then deep fried, and it has like this really vinegar, seems like kind of sweetish, probably mirin and maybe some soy sauce in it. It's very good. Eat it in that order if you'd like. That's what I suggest. But they're all really good. After that, we had this papaya salad, which is kind of like a very, 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 very trimmed down poke, or a very, very trimmed down ceviche. It's a little bit more like ceviche because it's got a bit of a vinegary thing. And yeah, the papaya is kind of sour, and then you put a little bit of this citrusy thing on top of it, if you like citrusy, soury stuff. And then it felt like it was tuna in terms of texture, but flavor wise it tasted a little bit different, but it was good. And then after that we had this, ooh, it got brighter, no, it didn't. And then we got this soup that was a clam soup, but had a strong crab taste in it, so I think it was like a crab broth that was going on in there, very strong, kind of reminds me of like a Chinese taste, and I think it should have dumplings in it, but it's just soup, a very light in terms of its thickness kind of soup. And then afterwards we had this grilled fish, which again, I don't know what kind of fish it is, but it is a white fish, and it was grilled, and then it had something like a squash in terms of texture. I don't really know what it is. I need to look up these things. And then my favorite, palong, it has some eggplant on it and a cucumber on the side, which I tried to eat. I actually ate it. Good job, me. But it was sort of like the cousin of zucchini. It's like in between a cucumber and zucchini. I don't know if it's just Palawan, but I don't know. I was able to eat it somehow. It had a hint of cucumber taste to it. And then we ordered more bread because we're hungry. And now we have the steak, so I'm gonna give you an update on what the steak tastes like. Hello again, so the return. I just tasted their Elilai beef steak, which was done in medium rare. It was very good. It tasted just like a well-made steak. It's very small. It's basically like a filet mignon, because it's very cute and tiny. It has the right flavors, salted properly. I guess it didn't have a lot of pepper, so you can feel free to add your own pepper. Also, I forgot to mention, so this is the Palau Lemon Pie, and it is a cocktail made out of shimachi nagomi and a local lemon, which is very, very sour. And not just sour, but it's got some bitterness to it. And also soda. And it's very good. You guys should try it. By the way, this shimachu nagomi is made locally in Palau, and it's made out of taro and cassava. Only in Palau. Delicious. Yes. Next up is dessert. So we're now at the rainbow's end. You know, at the end of the rainbow. Anyways, the name of the course is actually Rainbow's End Course. There's different kinds of course. There's the Milky Way course, and then there's the, I think that anyways, there's a special course. This is kind of like the mid-tier price one. It's somewhere around $60 per person. The dessert that I ordered is vanilla ice cream and warm chocolate cake. And then the other dish was a coconut ice cream. The coconut ice cream is served on top of a chunk of coconut with the coconut meat still on it. But that coconut white meat part is actually really tough, so I couldn't eat it because I thought, mottai nai, it's such a waste. But I couldn't eat it, it was tough. But the ice cream is really good, it's got like some dried coconut sprinkled on top, delicious. And the one that I ordered, the vanilla ice cream, is also very delicious, but the highlight is the chocolate, warm chocolate cake. It has a really strong, deep chocolate flavor. Try it out. And the play of the temperatures of cold and hot, standard awesomeness. Then it ends with either coffee or tea, and I got black coffee. Other things I want to say is get a reservation. They will pick you up from your hotel. That's nice. Also, they can reserve you to sit at the terrace, which is right in front of the sea. Let me show you the magnificent view that we can see tonight. That's right, the view is very dark. There's nothing at dinner time. So if you want to see the view, see it at lunchtime instead. That's what I suggest. And I think they have a lunch special, so. Alright, but I highly suggest Elilai. I think it holds the standards for being called the best restaurant in Palau. And also, thank you for all the Filipino workers who work in the restaurant. Salamat po. See you guys later.